Hey everybody, I'm back today to share some more relaxing, tingly time with you. And today, I thought I would do a bit of an ASMR throwback video. Since I've been away, I haven't really been keeping up with the ASMR scene at all. So I don't know if these videos are popular any longer. But today, I just wanted to do a little bit of a throwback tribute sort of video and show everyone what I have in my bag. And I've had this purse for quite some time now. As you can probably see, it's beginning to show a little bit of wear. And I initially intended to do this video when my purse was brand new, but just never got around to doing that. So I'm going to take some time out of my admittedly lazy Sunday and show you guys what I have lurking inside my bag, and hopefully just share some relaxing sounds with you. So I'm not sure if I can show you some of the features when it's full, but I'll try. So we have some zipper closures in the front, and these two front pockets here. And see what I'm up to. The other nice thing about this bag is it has some metal hardware, and it makes some nice tinkling sounds. And there's also the metal label on the front, designer's name. I'm not sure if you can see. But Sienna Ritchie. I found this bag at Kohl's. So it's nothing particularly special, I guess. But I'm very picky when it comes to purses. And so I was quite happy to find. I have some side pockets here, and a little keychain. But enough of that. Why don't we take a look and see what we have inside? We have these two outer pockets, and I normally don't keep much in here. I do have this, the code to a lock when I go to work out on my lunch break. It keeps things safe for me. And then in this pocket, I always carry some emergency earplugs. Do that in case I need to spend the night anywhere, or if I just forgot some earplugs when I've gone on vacation or something. This way I know I always have a pair, because I just can't sleep without them. I started using them in college and completely addicted. So that takes care of the front pockets. I want to make sure to make some good sounds for you while the bag is full, because I think it does change slightly when it's empty. And of course, that is part of the point, to create lots of relaxing sounds for you. And that's okay, because, as I said, today is just a relaxing, lazy Sunday. We don't have anywhere to be. We don't have anything to do. Some time together and enjoy this beautiful June day. Right now, the sun is shining in my office. Sunshine and the summer. So, this pocket here is where I normally keep my cell phone. It's convenient because with a bag this big, my phone is always getting lost. As you can see, there's nothing fancy about this phone. I have never used a smartphone before. I actually don't know how to use one. So I've just kept with these because I don't really have a need for anything else. And this works for now. Some junk in this pocket that I didn't clean out, because I will admit I did go through and just empty out some old receipts and things like that. My purse. just filled with various receipts and notes, other odds and ends. So I did tidy it up a little bit for the presentation today. And then there's normally nothing inside this back pocket. Okay. So now there are three pockets on the inside. There's one in the front here, a separate pocket in the middle, which is very convenient for storing things in a rainstorm. I seem to always be getting caught in the rain lately, so that's why I say that. Every time I need to venture out, I make sure to stow all my electronics in here, in the center pocket. And then the back pocket there. Let's start with the front. And it looks like in here I have my iPod. Right now, doesn't actually have any music. This is the one that I use in my car. So it also has an accompanying auxiliary cord. And it's tangled up. Music. Sometimes it has podcasts if I want to, just listen to a show that I've been anxious to hear, or just something motivational to keep me going on my runs. And I always carry this with me. To work out at lunch when I go to work. So I have that just in case. I don't think there's anything else in there. Middle section though. It is full of random things. I have my handy dandy notebook. I always carry this with me in case I need to just make a note of something that I need to pick up at the grocery store, or ideas for videos, or just random thoughts. So I make sure to always have that. My wallet. My aunt brought this back from China for me. And right now, it is just full of gift cards that need to be used. One to Walmart that I've evidently had since Christmas and just forgotten about. Secret gift card and a reward card to Vanity. The little zippered section is broken. It has seen better. I just have some change in the center there. So nothing too exciting. Let's see. Different types of hand sanitizer. This one, I'm not a huge fan of the scent, but the name is just Ducky, and my friend saw it and thought of me because that's my kitten's name, so she bought it for me. And I remember she just gave it to me on a day that, I don't know, I was feeling really down, and it just brightened my day. Another hand sanitizer. This one smells just like fall. And this is a coconut hand sanitizer. This little rubber carrier. I'm not entirely sure what the point of it is, but one isn't bad, but I'm not a huge fan of coconut. And in that same vein, I have some lotion. It is not the best lotion. I'm not very choosy. It's small, so it's easy to take with me. And it's good when you're in dire need of lotion. It's a little bit thin, as you can probably see. actually a very good cat. Just very playful and rambunctious. Car keys. And I also have a little shoe keychain. And I just love this thing. It's the cutest. Saucony shoe. My camera's not wanting to focus, but you can see that written on the heel. Tiny little insole, which you might not be able to see. And then there's a little piece of tissue paper in the toe. I went to great lengths to make it authentic. I also have a Band-Aid, because you never know when you'll need one of those. Gum. I am a chewing gum addict, so that's something I always need to have on hand. Along with plenty of pens. Whatever notes I need to take. Another notebook. This one's obviously much smaller. Various lip balms. This one is apparently very popular. This company, but I'm not a huge fan of it. I don't think it glides very easily, and it's just not as smooth as I would. Received it as a gift, so I use it when I can. It's not too bad. The Burt's Bees is also not my favorite. And neither is the one is very strongly scented, so it's a pretty color, but I can't get over the taste of it. It's awful. I'm not even sure why I carry it around, honestly, if I never wear it, but there you go. I enjoyed this one a lot. Going to come undone in your purse. It also had sunscreen, which I like. A Sharpie that I have for some reason, along with two packets of mustard. I'm in desperate need of it. Some cold medicine. This is a holdover from winter. And a hairbrush. I know you're very familiar with this brush by now, but I still love the sound it makes. And that just about does it for that pocket. In the very back, I have some deodorant. Again, for use at the gym. Very important to have that. Some sunglasses. And heart rate monitor. But I think that just about does it. That's pretty much everything that I carry with me on a day-to-day basis. So, as you can imagine, the bag can get very heavy sometimes, and it can be difficult to find things in it when I need them, but that's one of the sacrifices you make for so much storage space. So now I think I'll bring the camera up and show you some of the details. Just demonstrate a few more of the features for you. I love the hollow sound of the label. And the bag is also just made of a very soft, kind of almost cushy material. So it feels good to just kind of squeeze in your hands. Let's see here. There's also whatever this plastic material is in the bottom. And then the leather part in the front is just that soft fake suede. Not suede, but I don't know, just a fake leather texture. It's flaking away in some places. I've had this bag for at least a year, over a year. Can tell it's definitely seen better days. I also really like the lining. And all of the different zippers and compartments. I should probably readjust my camera. I will do that. And make some more sounds for you with the purse on the ground, since that's more convenient. But I'm happy to finally get to share it with you guys and just show it to you, because I've been meaning to forever and I just never did get around to it. I'll have more sounds ready for you, I promise. Okay. So here we are. I feel like it's always so hard for me to end these videos, because there's always something new that I want to show you, or I'll feel like I just didn't spend enough time with something. Always some reason not to stop filming. also just obviously a more convenient position. But I also like talking to you guys face to face. I feel very sad looking at my back this way because I just see the areas that are starting to wear on it, and I just wonder how much time we have left together. As I said, I've had it for well over a year. And I'm going to be very sad to see it go. I'm very picky when it comes to my purses, so not like some people that have many different bags and change their bag depending on their outfit. That's way too complicated for me. I'm more of a one-size-fits-all kind of person. At least where this sort of thing is concerned. Overall, though, I'm fairly happy with the way that it's held up. As far as purses go, it's not, or it wasn't overly expensive. But, I don't know, I also don't particularly understand. I know some people enjoy that, but I just could never really get into that sort of thing. I just like what I like, and for some reason there was just something about the color and the style of this particular bag that just struck me. I will be sad to see it go, but I'm sure I'll find something else I like. After a suitable period of mourning, of course. Thank you. and everything. Now would be a good time to begin putting everything back. I wish I could say that everything is always this organized, but that is almost never the case. Found the hair tie, I realized it. My hair tie compartment. I also have a necklace hiding in there. So, of course, having hair like mine, I always need steady supply of hair accessories and a little spin bin. And this is my Pocahontas necklace. There's a little hummingbird. Replace my shoe. I'd be lost without it. Thank you. There you have it. I hope that you enjoyed the tour of my pack. When I do cave in and buy a new one, I'll be sure to demonstrate that one for you as well. More videos.